can you please come out of your office?
Some things that we're going to start with here, and we always talk about standard form in the parent function. Y equals A times the sine B of X is standard form of your sine function, A sine B of X. It could be F of X, remember that's the same as Y. Y equals A times the cosine B of X. Let me scoop that A over there closer. They'll always be close together. I made it spaced out too far. There you go. All right. Now that A and B is important stuff because when we start graphing these things, we're going to have to identify specific parts. One of the parts that we're going to have to identify is called the amplitude. And luckily amplitude is easy to remember because amplitude starts with an A and it comes from the A spot of our standard form. It's the absolute value of A, which just means your amplitude will always be positive. Okay, actual definition for an amplitude, it's one half the difference between the maximum and the minimum. I know that doesn't mean a lot to you right now, but just a little bit, a fast forward, what you're fixing to see. This is what sine and cosine graphs look like. So the amplitude, if this is your max and this is your minimum, amplitude is half that distance. So it would be how far you are, like there or there. That's what you're actually finding when you find amplitude. That's why it's always positive, because the distance is always positive. Gracie.
Can you see the textbook definition again for that? So I can write it down.
Yep. Amplitude of the graph of a function is one half the difference of the maximum and the minimum. One half the difference of the maximum and the minimum.
It's the same thing. One half the difference of the maximum.
Yep. All right, now, where the B becomes important, what's in the B spot, is we're going to be asked to identify periods. I'll give you a defo of periods in just a second, but to find the period of these, it's always going to be 2 pi divided by your B. Okay? I'm going to read you a little short two-line paragraph here. It says, each function is periodic. What that means is that it just keeps going in the same cycle. Each function is periodic, which means that the graph has repeating patterns. The shortest repeating portion is called a cycle. The horizontal length of the cycle is called a period. Okay, so if I go back and start drawing this thing again, you could say that that is what repeats, right? I see that keep going, that mountaintop. It keeps going, keeps going, keeps going. So that would be a cycle. How long it is called the period. Okay, and you find that by doing 2 pi divided by b. I know it's a bunch of mumbo jumbo, but these four, it's easy to work with, so don't get bogged down on technicalities.
Wait, so what is your, what is your b, like 2 pi divided by b,
there'll be a number in that spot.
Oh, so it'll give you that.
Mm-hmm. Okay. This is just standard form. There won't be a's and b's, there'll be numbers.
Oh, sorry.
That's okay.
The
horizontal length of a cycle. Alright, now, to add on to our list of new stuff here, x-intercepts when it's a sine function, so let me write x-intercepts of y equals a sine b of x, will be at x equals, and we got a whole list of them here, 0 plus or minus pi plus or minus 2 pi plus or minus 3 pi, dot, dot, dot. So what that means, this is where a sine graph is going to cross the x-axis. So this would be your 0, and then the next time it crosses will be at pi and negative pi, and then at 2 pi, and then at negative 2 pi. That's just telling you what all your x-intercepts are going to be. Okay? Now we're also going to have x-intercepts on a cosine. They're a little bit different. That was sine. See, it says sine there. X-intercepts of a cosine are going to be, it doesn't have zero. It's got plus or minus half pi, plus or minus 3 pi over 2, plus or minus 5 pi over 2 plus minus 7 pi over 2. Blah, blah, blah. So they're moving in half pies. Well, they're actually moving in one pi. They just started a half. Instead of starting at 0, they started a half. That's all. It's so shifted over a little bit.
The last one's like pi.
Yep. All right, I know it's a struggle to you in the beginning because I always like to get all the new stuff out there first and then start working with it. And it's a struggle because it seems hard when you look at all that new stuff. But now when we start using it, working with it, we'll get all the fogginess cleared up on it. So everybody got what you need off that, and we can actually try to figure something out. All right, so let's see if I can write myself on. Okay, I've got, go ahead and get a piece of graph edit over here. All right, I've got here y equals 4 sine of x. All right, here's our definition, our directions. Here's our directions. It says identify the amplitude and period. So we're going to figure out what's the amplitude, what's the period, then graph. So we got three tasks. Now, the amplitude and the period are what's going to help you put your graph on there. So those, anytime you're graphing, you're always going to find the amplitude and the period first. You ought to be able to look at it and know the amplitude. Amplitude is the absolute value of A, so it's always positive. Ours is positive, so it's good. What's in the A spot on that?
4.
So my amplitude is 4. Okay, everybody all right on that? Now the period we do has a little smidgen of math because you do 2 pi divided by B. What's in our B spot? How many X's are there?
1.
1, so it's just 2 pi.
So you
leave
it
5
to 5?
Yep.
2
pi divided by B. What's in our B spot? How many X's are there?
One.
You don't do. Okay, now, to get those intercepts that we looked at a second ago, there's going to be a little bit, because that's the last thing that I need before I graph them, there's going to be a little bit more work involved when it's not a, get a dry erase marker. I'm struggling to figure out where to write everything. When it's not, when your A is, that was based on the A just being A. But where'd that come from? I better slow down, don't you think? I've been bad at like whacking you or something. Anyway, I've already lost my train of thought. Was I talking about anything that mattered?
Probably.
Okay, so these intercepts on, this is on our sine function here. There's your 0, 0. Okay, here would be a maximum. This maximum, it's going to be 1 fourth times 2 pi over b, comma, your amplitude. So to find that ordered pair for that mountaintop, you're going to do 1 fourth times your period. That'll get the x. And then your amplitude will be your y. That, remember, the amplitude is half the distance. So this is your midline right now. Midline is a word we've got to talk about. It's the midline, so that would be the halfway. Okay? Then to get, there's going to, you need these formulas. To get this one, see, I don't know, memorize. It's a half times the period, which is pi over b. And I'll explain to you where that half and everything comes from in just a second. To get your minimum, 3 fourths times 2 pi over b. And I'm down now, so it would be negative 8. And then my here would be my period, 2 pi over b, 0. All right. Where do those fractions come from that we're looking at on the...
Good view, that's all. other.
Well, we haven't done anything yet. These are the formulas to help you figure out how to draw your graph. All right, this makeup graph that I've drawn, this is just a generic sine graph. It's not anything specific, just a generic. Let me write my parrot form there again. Y equals A sine B of X, okay? Generic sine graph. This that I've drawn, and this is a common trick thing. They're always going to say, draw the graph in the interval between 0 and 2 pi, or something along those lines. Or they'll say, draw one cycle, something like that. So here's the way Dr. Ike's silly brain thinks. I got to draw at least all the way to the top of the mountain and all the way to the valley. So that's what you're always going to have to draw. Okay, that part of it. Does it keep going? Yes. These things are periodic. It's like one of those heart rate monitors. You're going to keep going positive and negative both ways. But you have to draw at least a mountaintop and a valley. Okay? So that would be considered whole. That's one. So to get to this, if this is one, that's a quarter of the way. Because this thing would split up. Here would be half, right? So then half of that's a quarter. That's where that one-fourth comes from. Your whole period, this whole thing, is 2 pi over b. So I do a quarter of that to get here, a half of the whole thing. Here I'm 3/4 of the whole thing. And then there you're the whole thing. That's where those crazy numbers come from. So on this thing, if I've got that turned on or not, I need it off. Yeah. To start ours, we're going to be here, maybe. Okay, our period, 2 pi over 1 is 2 pi, right? So our first one is going to be 1/4 times 2 pi, which would be what?
I got like 1.9.
No, don't do that. What's 2/4 the same as? A half, so that would be a half pi, and what's our A? Right? So my first point that I'm going to plot is a half pi 4. These graphs are always going to be based on in terms of pi. So if my whole period is 2 pi, I just need to figure out how I want to divide this thing up. It doesn't really matter. I want it to be nice and pretty so I can draw my, I don't want it all scrunched up or anything. I want to be able to draw my mountain and my valley pretty spread out. So if I got to go, my period's got to be 2 pi. I'm going to be going up, down, and ending at 2 pi. So I'm going to make that, I just picked that, be 2 pi. I might 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'll be better off if I moved it here because that's even. So let me do that. Alright, so then halfway, 1 pi, half of that 1 pi would be halfway between there. So there's 1 pi. Right? Halfway between 1 pi would be a half pi. And halfway between here would be 1.5 pi. Alright? It's all based off of my period of 2 pi. So I just split my intervals from there. I found my period was 2 pi, so I put that somewhere where I could cut it in half, because I went over to 6, so I could cut it in half at 3. Then I halved those to get that jump. All right, so my first one would be I go over to pi over 2 and up to 4. All right. Then it says we get this one by doing a half times our period. So I'm going to do a half times 2 pi. Sydney took your stuff.
Oh, how sweet. Thank you.
You're welcome. Have a good day.
Thank you.
So that will get you just pi, right? So that's going to be pi 0. Now I'm going to go ahead and figure this one, my next one out mathematically, but once you get that one, it's just going to be the negative of it. You're going to come over to the next one and go negative, but it would be 3/4 times your period. So fourths times 2 pi. 2 over 4 is the same as 1 half. So that's 3 pi over 2, which is where I was at. And then negative 8. So negative 4. So I'm here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so you can start envisioning. You've got your mountain. You've got your valley. You're ready to get back here, right? So you've got your last one is just 2 pi, 0. So everything that we've got there, this distance would be your amplitude. That's the 4 that we got. This whole distance is the period. Okay? All right, we're going to do some hole. That's just a starting spot for you. It just is your period, comma, 0. So there wasn't really any work to do on that. 2 pi over b, which is your period. Comma, negative 4, yeah. Because that's the order pair. Because the 2 over 4 reduces to 1 over 2, so that's why that turns it. G of x is equal to 5 times the sine of x. Alright, so what's my amplitude?
5.
5, very good. And for today, this is just a little hint for you. For today, the midline on all of these is going to be the x-axis. Later, we'll start shifting them up and down, but today they're going to... Well, I say that, now flip the page and see some. So for right now, rewind, for right now the midline's the x-axis. In a little bit we'll shift them up and down. But that since the midline's the x-axis, that means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, that's going to be as high as I go, and negative 5 will be as low as I go. That's what it means when you find the amplitude when your midline is the axis. Our period...
Well, how do you know the midline is...
There's nothing extra stuck out. Remember, like, we always had a plus or minus stuck out. It's the same stuff on this. If there's something plus 1, we would scoot everything up 1. Okay. Our period, our b is 1 again. So our period is 2 pi over b, so it's still 2 pi. Okay, didn't change that time. One, two, three, four, five, six. I'm always going to do my period on an even number when I make my increments. You can make them anywhere you want as long as you label them. But then I know if I do it even, then I can half it easy to find my one pi. Because these increments are pretty standard. These are the increments you're going to want every time. And then half of that will fall on the middle there. And half will fall on the middle there. Now, does that mean, I'm telling you, those are the increments you're going to use every time, but when they start scooting, sometimes it might be a fourth pi. I'll just know that a fourth is halfway between there. You just have to use common sense on that. All right, so now we're looking at the dry erase board over there on how to find our ordered pair. To get our maximum value, we're going to do 1/4 times our period, and then our y will be a. So 1/4 times 2, that's 1/2. So we'll go over a half pi and up to 5. Gonna start, I left off the 0, 0 to start. Okay, everybody good on that? Then to find our next, we already got 0, 0. Find our next x-intercept, we're gonna do 1/2 times our period. Uh-huh. It'll be 0. 1/2 times 2 is just 1 pi, so it'll be at pi 0. Okay. Then I'm just over there with the dry erase board down to that bottom valley. So I'm going to do 3/4 times my period. And then that will be negative a, so that is 3/2 pi. With negative 5, so I gotta scroll down just a smidge to get that negative 5 down there. And then my last one is just my period, comma 0. So 2 pi, comma 0. Not a whole lot different on that one. It just goes higher and lower because it had an amplitude of 5 instead of 4.
So is there going to be a different formula to find your points if you have B and not A? Like if it doesn't give you an A, but it gives you B.
If it doesn't give you an A, it'll be a 1. There has to be something in the A spot or it would just be a line. All right, want to look at the cosine stuff. I'll draw, let's see. If I draw it over here on this one, can y'all look over here and see so I can put the stuff that we got there? All right, this will be y equals a times the cosine b of x. And notice what's different looking on this cosine one that I'm going to draw. Okay, so normally on the sine, I started here. So it's like it just scooted it right a little bit, didn't it? That would still keep repeating and still make that same roller coaster shape, but it's high here instead of here. Does that kind of make a little bit of sense? So what you're looking at on this, and it's what David said, my whole complete cycle, my period, would be I started on the mountain, went in the valley, and came back to the mountain. All right, so our formulas here for this one, this is 0 and your amplitude. That's a pretty obvious one to you there. This one is 1/4 times your period. And it's comma 0. This one is 1/2 times your period. And it's negative a. This one is 3/4 times your period. And it's at 0. And then this one is your period. A. This one is 3/4 times your period 0. And then the last one up here is your period, comma A, your angle 2. Is there any other ones y'all need me to? I know it's a long way and small for some of you. Questions? So let's see if we can graph a cosine function now. Alright, I've got here g of x is equal to 1/2. Oops, the other way there, box. 1/2 cosine 2πx. Alright, so we added some stuff that we didn't do yet with the sine, so this will be some good math for you on this. Amplitude and period on cosine are the same, so what's our amplitude?
1/2.
Okay, so that means this thing's going to be pretty short and squatty, doesn't it? From the midline, I'm only going to go up 1/2 and down 1/2. Now, you might, that would be there on the way I normally do it. I might want to count different on this. You think that'd be all right if I counted different, or would it bother y'all? Y'all just want me to, nobody's telling me.
Just do it different.
Okay. I'm going to say that, let's see, there's going to be 1/2 for me, and there's going to be 1/-2 for me. Okay? All right, well, my period is 2π. Divided by B, what's in my B spot? 2π. I like this. When I don't have to mess with pi, because 2π divided by 2π is 1. My x increments are easy to figure out now, because you don't have that pi in there. I don't just want to go over 1, because it's going to be pretty hard to fit a whole graph in that little space. So, based on the way I made my y-axis, 1, 2, 3, 4 would be 1, wouldn't it? I got it from doing 2π divided by b, and 2π was in my b spot. You got it. Okay, so there's going to be 1 for me, which means there would be 1/2, which means there would be 1/4, which means there would be 3/4. Alright, now we got to find those points to get. This, the first one up there, it is just 0, comma, your amplitude. So I'm going to go over 0 and up 1/2. Bam. Okay, then to get your first intercept, your x-intercept, it was 1/4 times your period. That's easy. 1/4 times 1, comma, 0. So that's 1/4, 0. Where am I getting this 1/4 stuff? Off that dry erase board on your left that you copied down. I'm using those formulas right now. To get my next point, it's 1/2 times my period, comma, negative A. 1/2 times 1 is 1/2, negative A. That 1 makes work easy right now, doesn't it? Okay, then to get my next one, it's 3/4 times my period, comma 0. then my last one is my period, which is 1, comma, A. Well, because you had, oops, I can't get that point. Because you had 2 to practice with already, and because of the 1. Y'all don't like fractions, so y'all don't like those other ones. So what now, Willis? Well, not really. It looks, what I've drawn does look like a V, but you have to remember that these graphs, this would actually keep repeating. I just drew that one section of it, right? Everybody remember what Malia just talked about? This thing would actually keep on going, trucking on, but I just drew that one section of it, one period of it, one cycle of it, right? Cycle. All right, let's do another. Let's look at g of x is equal to 2 sine 4 of x plus 3. All right, now here's what I was talking about earlier. I was talking to Kylie about it. This one's got a plus 3 on the end. So that means that it's going to be scooted up 3. Remember those translations that we've done on every kind of graph we've done? If there's something plus or minus stuck out on the end, that's how far you scoot up or down. So normally my midline's been here at the x-axis. I'm scooting that up 3. So that is going to be my midline now. Okay?
So don't worry about the middle.
Now the middle's going to be up here now. You're right. Okay, what's the amplitude of this thing? So if the amplitude's 2, that means it's 2 from the midline. So the highest up I'm going to go is 2 up from that, and the lowest I'm going to go is 2 down from that.
So would that mean 1, 2, 3, 4, 5?
Oh, that up
like
there?
Like the highest you would go is 5, and the lowest you would go is 1.
Yes. All right, our period is 2 pi over b, which would be, our b is what? No.
4
x. Just
I
4.
I stay out there all day. But I doubt it even would be big.
Yeah.
I see about playing music Thursday.
Have you heard from you?
No.
Okay. Well, let me know because I got to make plans for Wednesday if you do Wednesday. So our period now is going to be pi over 2. So it's just a half pi. Okay, those first ones that we did, it was 2 pi, right? The period was 2 pi. Now it's a half pi. I don't want to just go shorter, though. I still want to be able to draw a big picture, so I'm going to draw a half pi all the way out here. And then to cut that in half, that would be a quarter pi, right? What do you get when you cut a quarter in half? An eighth, very good. And then what would be halfway between a quarter and a whole? 3/8, right? Good job, David, on your fractions there. Okay, let's see if we can figure those points out now. We got first one at 0, 0, but it's not at 0, 0. Because we scooted our midline up to here, right? So my first one's going to be there. Okay, to get that next one, and this is sine, so that's the graph up here in the front of you by David. It's going to be 1/4 times my period, and my amplitude. So 1/4 times pi over 2 is pi over 8. So I'm going to be at, go over to pi over 8, and then I'm going up to my amplitude up there where I drew that first line at.
I have a question.
Yes, ma'am.
How'd you get your first point?
Please excuse the interruption. If there is anyone else that needs to be fitted for a text, please go to the center's office at this time.
I took my 0, 0 and scooted it up to my midline.
Oh, it's sine. I was looking at the wrong one.
All right, so now I'm to my one half times my period, commas. It's comma zero, but my zero is moved up now, right? All my zeros are scooted up three. All my amplitudes are scooted up three. So that would make 1/4 pi. Okay, then my minimum will be 3/4 times my period, which is 3/8 pi. And then my negative amplitude. And then my last one is my period. So it would look like that. So it's the same thing, it's just scooted up three. I've seen people do these before. The first, where they do it opposite of what I did. The first thing I did was I got my up three started. So I drew my midline up there. Some people will save that for the last. They'll graph this thing down here like we did the first ones and get their graph. And then they'll scoot the whole graph up three. Some people like to do it that way. It doesn't matter. Just scoot it up three at the beginning or scoot it up three at the end. But you have to scoot it up three. Okay?
What if it's at minus three?
Then you've scooted it down three.
Maybe you need to go around.
Yes, but I don't think we're going to get to it today.
Down.
If it were right or left, it would have to be in, it would be with the X. It wouldn't be stuck out on the end. So it would be like, to show you what it would look like, you could have like 2 sine of 3 X minus 4. So it would have to be in a parenthesis with the X if it was left or right.
Sorry,
husband, that's okay. All right, good deal. We'll stop it for there today. Just because.